Welcome to The Way to Build Wealth. I'm Ethan Block, and I'm helping you build some wealth on a Wednesday. And as we always do on Wednesday, wine? Wednesday. Today we're drinking Vista Hermosa from Spain. And what's weird about it just says red wine. So we're drinking a red wine. Let's give it a whirl. Whoa, I spilt that. How's everybody doing, by the way? It's Wednesday, middle of the week. You're like, yeah, weekend's coming up, Thursday, Friday-ish. My sister actually hates Wednesdays. I don't know, what about you? Like Wednesdays, I don't mind them. I'm cool, wine Wednesday, right? Let's do it. It's not too bad. It's not too bad, it's like a So I've definitely had plenty of better cheap red wines, coming in at $4. I would give it like on a 1 to 10 scale, maybe a 5. Not too bad. And that's all I gotta say about that. Let's get right into the show. Today I'm going over an index fund checklist. And this is something I put together for you to use to basically apply, well, this is my shorthand list, but for you to apply to any index funds you're thinking about investing in. Now, I've already recommended what I believe to be the best index funds from Charles Schwab, Vanguard, and Fidelity. However, you know, maybe you don't wanna listen to me. More power to you. You know, you're thinking on your own. That's a good thing. If you're gonna do that, I'm still giving you some points to apply, to make sure you don't get taken advantage of, to make sure you don't get ripped off. I'm linking up the list down there. It's a little pocket list. You can print it out, stick it in your pocket, and carry it everywhere you go. You know, you may just be sitting at work or maybe sitting in class and be like, oh, I want to look at the index fund checklist. I'm putting my picture on the list. You can look at me too, you know, have me in your pocket. That's kind of weird. Let's get right into it. I actually, now I'm thinking about it, I'm not going to go over each item for the sake of it. I'm just going to go over what I think are the three most important ones. So let's just do it. The biggest one is probably, what are the index funds fees? Meaning, what is the expense ratios? This is big because some index funds charge obnoxious fees and are just gouging their customers because they can. And the price or the fee point is 0.5%. If an index fund has a higher expense ratio than 0.5%, forget about it. Don't pay attention. You know, there is one exception with the International Index Fund by Charles Schwab. It's 0.65%. If you have a Schwab account and you want to do it, you know, go for it. But, you know, more than 0.5%, and I'm going to be honest with you, what George Carlin said, actually not going to get graphic, but you're getting ripped off big time, so look out for that. Especially, I'm probably getting too much, but Vanguard and Fidelity, they charge like from 0.1 to 0.16% are their expense ratios. So I'm being generous at a 0.5%. All right. Another big one is the minimum initial and minimum additional investment requirements. Minimum initial means the amount of money you have to put in to get into the action. It's a big deal because if you don't have enough money for a particular index fund, you can't get in the action. But bigger than that, once you're in the index fund, what's the minimum additional investment? Meaning how much money do you have to bring to the table to continually invest in the fund every month or every week? And this is big because, as I say, you want to constantly be socking money away, especially in times like these, be buying into the market weekly, monthly. And if the bar is set too high, you're not going to be able to contribute every month because you don't make enough money. So look at that. It's big. And apply that to what your income is and pick one that kind of fits and suits your needs. It's not a one-size-fits-all in this business. And the last one is, hold on, I think I skipped one. No, I didn't. Okay, the last one is continue to invest in your index funds throughout your life. This isn't buy and sit. This is buy, 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 buy. I could say it 150,000 times for every day of your life. How many days are in a lifetime? I don't even know. You know, but just keep buying. That's the key to this. Just keep putting in your money and you will be blown away with the amount of wealth you will accumulate later in your life. That's the index fund checklist, my three favorite from it. Linking it up down there. Thanks for tuning in. We'll see you tomorrow. Another great Wine Wednesday here on the Way to Build Wealth with me, Ethan Block, helping you build some wealth.